So this next song is by the writing team of John Kander and Fred Ebb. And if you think you don't know who they are, you do, I promise. They wrote the musical Cabaret, they wrote the musical Chicago, they wrote Kiss of the Spider Woman, and even if you still don't think you know who they are, they wrote a song that goes dun dun da 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 dun dun da da da. Y'all know that song. Everybody knows that song. That is John Kander and Fred Ebb, and this is a song that they wrote for their muse as they were all young and growing up. They wrote this song for Miss Liza Minnelli, and now we're going to try to sing it ourselves. Here we go. Hit it, Andy. Gather around, I've got a story to tell about a Manhattan lady that I know very well. She lives at 5 Riverside, her name is Shirley DeVore, and she traveled round the world to meet the guy next door. Now there was trouble inside apartment 29E, 'cause Shirley's mother and dad were as upset as can be. They said, "We hate to complain, dear, and we don't like to grouse, but you're nearly 32. You should get out of the house. You gotta ring them bells, you gotta ring them bells. You gotta make them sing and really ring them bells. It's such a happy thing to hear them tinkling. You gotta ring them bells." Well, Shirley was 31, which she was loath to admit, and she had never been loved, which didn't thrill her a bit. And so she sat and she thought for hours on end, and said, "I'll go to Chase Manhattan, where I got me a friend." And so she borrowed a thou and called TWA and told her mother and dad that she was up and away. "I'm gonna travel the continent a month, maybe two, and haul me home a huzz if it's the last thing I do. I gotta ring them bells, I gotta ring them bells. I gotta make them sing and really ring them bells. It's such a happy thing to hear them tingling. I gotta ring them bells." She met a Londoner first, but they did not hit it off, 'cause every time she'd approach, he'd get a bronchial cough. And so she went to Madrid and met a handsome señor, but he liked to throw the bull and he was no matador.
Gracias.
She also bombed out in Brussels, in Mallorca, and Rome, till someone said, "Do try Dubrovnik, dear, before you go home, 'cause it's the kind of a town where you'll be likely to fall, and all the Tony Cognoscenti find the Balkans a ball. You've simply got to ring them bells, you've got to ring them bells, you've got to make them sing and really let them. It's such a happy thing to hear them ting-a-ling. You've got to ring them bells." And so she went to Dubrovnik, and the very first day she met a guy on the beach who took her reason away. Yes, it was love at first sight and quite a beautiful scene. She said, "My name is Cheryl DeVore." He said, "I'm Norm Saperstein." She said, "Are you in New York?" He said, "That can't be denied. I've got a swell junior 3 at number 5 Riverside."
5 Riverside Drive in New York, 12345. "That's where you live?" "But that's where I live." "Well, I've never seen you, and I go out on the, and we're all the way, and I can't, oh, I can't breathe, and I don't even know what you said." "Are you sure?"
As if that wasn't enough, poor Shirley thought she'd gone deaf when he told her his apartment there was 29F. Yes, she was E, he was F, and they had not even met until she traveled the world to Yugoslavia yet. He'd always been right next door, and she would never have known. If she hadn't tried Dubrovnik, she might still be alone. live in apartments. Don't